माय चैनल डॉक्टर दीपा डाके इज नीड बायोलॉजी एंड आई एम डॉक्टर दीपा डाके डायरेक्टर एट बायोजोन क्लासेस जबलपुर. इन टुडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम क्लास 12th सिलेबस दैट इज डीएनए रेप्लिकेशन. सो इन टुडेज सेशन वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट वॉट इज डीएनए रेप्लिकेशन. What are the phases when the DNA replication is take place? And secondly, the main experimental proof for the semi-conservative mode of DNA replication we discuss. And then we come towards the mechanism of DNA replication. So students, let's begin with DNA replication. So as you all know, DNA replication when we study. So in DNA replication, you remember, the process of replication means simply you remember the process of duplication of DNA. Simply हम कह रहे हैं so process of duplication of DNA or the process in which new identical copies of DNA are form. So the process by which you simply remember the process by which the parental DNA form a new identical copy. Those process or that process you remember is called as DNA replication. Now when will be the processes take place? So here you remember the DNA replication or DNA synthesis is predominantly take place during the S phase or synthetic phase of the cell cycle. And synthetic phase in cell cycle is present during the interphase. So here you remember, simply for recalling purpose, you remember the S phase show the process of DNA replication. When we study about the phenomena of replication, so here we study the what kind of replications are there. So basically three different types of replications are there. Conservative replication, semi-conservative replication and dispersive mode of replication. But by experimental proof it is proved that the DNA replication is mainly take place by semi-conservative mode. So here you remember replication is always semi-conservative. Semi-conservative means the 50% DNA is a parental DNA and the 50% DNA is a newly synthesized DNA. So that's, you remember, this is the semi-conservative mode of replication. Now to explain this method, the most important experiment performed by the scientist Meselson and Stahel. So here you remember Meselson and Stahel perform the experiment for proving semi-conservative mode of replication. And this experiment, basically the experiment is based on use of E. coli. They select the E. coli because the replication cycle of E. coli is completed in 20 minutes. Third, aap yaad rakhe, when we study the Meselson and Stahel experiment, one of the most important question from this experiment is commonly asked, that is the what kind of isotopes used by the Meselson and Stahel. So in this you remember during their experiment they used the heavy isotopes. These are not radioisotopes, these are the heavy density isotopes of अमोनियम क्लोराइड NH4Cl के फॉर्म में यूज किया है. एंड दीज हैवी आइसोटोप्स बेसिकली यू रिमेंबर N14 एंड N15 आर देयर. सो दिस पार्ट यू रिमेंबर, सो दीज आर द सिंपली हैवी डेंसिटी आइसोटोप्स ऑफ द NH4Cl N14 एंड N15. सेकेंडली फॉर द एक्सपेरिमेंट अगेन वॉट काइंड ऑफ मेथड इज यूज फॉर द आइसोलेशन ऑफ DNA. That part you remember. So cesium chloride density gradient mechanism, you remember the cesium chloride density mechanism or method, sorry, method is used by Meselson and Stahel for isolation of the DNA. So this part you remember for mainly semi-conservative mode of replication and the experiment of Meselson and Stahel. Now we come towards the replication when we study the DNA. So in during DNA replication, what are the major requirements are there? And then we come, how does the replication phenomena is take place? When we study about the requirements, so in terms of requirements, you remember, firstly, the four different types of nucleotides we required. I hope you all are knowing what is nucleotides and what is the basic difference between nucleotide and nucleoside. So nucleotides, nucleotides of adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosines are required because these are the four nitrogen bases which are predominantly present in the polynucleotide chains of the DNA. So nucleotides of adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine are required. Second requirement, you remember, the second requirement is there, one molecule of primer is present required there because the DNA polymerase enzyme, which is main enzyme for the DNA synthesis, DNA polymerase never be bind directly to the third end of parental DNA. That's why for the binding of DNA polymerase, we required the primer. After that, the third requirement is there. The third requirement, you remember, this is the different kinds of enzymes are required. And this is one of the most important part for the DNA replication, that how does the different enzyme play significant role during the process of and DNA replication. And after that, when we study, so again one of the most important, that is ATP. ATP, adenosine triphosphate, is mainly utilized at the time of denaturation of DNA. What is denaturation? When the double, during the DNA replication, first double-stranded DNA get converted into single-stranded DNA. So the conversion of double-stranded DNA into single-stranded DNA is generally, you remember, called as denaturation. And to break the hydrogen bonds present between adenine, thymine and guanine, cytosine, the process is totally dependent on the ATP. So these four major requirements for the DNA replication. Now first we come towards the enzymatic requirement, that what are the different enzymes required in the process of DNA replication. This is important part for your upcoming NEET exams. So enzymatic requirement here we study, and secondly this only I explain here for the your upcoming NEET exam. So most of the important points I discuss here. Enzymatic requirement when we study, so first most important enzyme is there, that is called as helicase. Helicase, you remember, commonly helicase is called as unwinding enzyme. So unwinding enzyme aap keh rahe hain, that means the enzyme which required to convert double stranded DNA into single stranded DNA, this enzyme is called as helicase. So the double helical DNA become a single stranded DNA. Now question yahan pe aata hai, what is the site of helicase, activity site? So here you remember, helicase enzyme, whenever you study, helicase is predominantly present on the hydrogen bonds of the DNA. So two polynucleotide chains are bind with hydrogen bonds, and the helicase enzyme break hydrogen bond by utilizing ATP. For every hydrogen bond, you remember, for each and every hydrogen bond, the one ATP is required. So the question again from this part is also asked, that the DNA when rich in guanine and cytosine, so the DNA required more ATP because when we study, the G and C show the triple hydrogen bonds, and in between A and T, two hydrogen bonds are present. This bonding you already study and know. So whenever there is a huge ratio of GC in DNA, in that condition, to isolate the one base pair or to separate one base pair, three ATPs are required. The second, now we come towards the second class of enzyme. Second class of enzyme, student, remember here, the second class of enzyme is predominantly DNA polymerase. एंड डीएनए पॉलीमरेज यू रिमेम्बर कॉमनली कॉल्ड ए सिंथेटिक एंजाइम. सो डीएनए पॉलीमरेज इज अ सेकेंड क्लास ऑफ एंजाइम एंड दिस एंजाइम प्रीडोमिनेंटली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ डॉटर डीएनए और द आइडेंटिकल कॉपीज ऑफ द डीएनए. सो एंटायर डीएनए रेप्लिकेशन यू रिमेम्बर इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द यूटिलिटी ऑफ डीएनए पॉलीमरेज. नाउ देयर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ डीएनए पॉलीमरेज दैट इज कॉमनली कॉल्ड एज डीएनए पॉलीमरेज 1, पॉलीमरेज 2 एंड पॉलीमरेज 3. सो हियर यू एज वी डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक ओनली फॉर द नीट एग्जाम. सो यू ओनली रिमेम्बर द डीएनए पॉलीमरेज 3 इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कैटेगरी बिकॉज दिस इज द वन एंड ओनली एंजाइम विच कैन सिंथेसाइज द डीएनए इन फॉरवर्ड एज वेल एज बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द यूज ऑफ डीएनए पॉलीमरेज 3 और पॉल 3 यू रिमेम्बर द डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए विल बी सिंथेसाइज. सो हियर यू रिमेम्बर whenever we discuss about the DNA replication predominantly involve the utility of the polymerase 3. Now the third category of enzyme is there. This third category of enzyme is called as ligase. Ligase, you remember, ligase is a gap sealing enzyme or nick sealing enzyme hum keh rahe hain. So whenever there is a gap or a fragmentation present for a single base or single base pair, then to join the two DNA segments, we use the ligase enzyme. So DNA replication involves the third most important enzyme, that is ligase. Where this ligase is used? So you remember, when we study the replication of DNA, so on lagging strand show the process formation of Okazaki fragments. So on lagging strands, Okazaki fragments, you remember, joined by or connected by. So Okazaki fragments connected by ligase activity. So these three important class of enzyme, you remember, were first is helicase. When you study about the helicase, so sometime in reference book you study about topoisomerase, gyrase, so that is a different part, but for revision purpose you remember three enzymes are there: helicase, DNA polymerase, that is polymerase 3, and ligase. Now we come towards the mechanism of DNA replication, that how does the process of replication is take place. Now when begins with DNA replication, so first you clearly differentiate between the lagging strand and leading strand. What is the direction of lagging and leading strand, and for which purpose we use these two terms, that is lagging and leading strand. So when we study about the DNA, so here normally we draw replication mechanism. Now we study here, so here we remember mechanism हम study कर रहे हैं, mechanism of DNA replication. Now two strands of DNA are there, so adenine, thymine, cytosine, guanine, cytosine, adenine. Suppose this strand is having forward direction. Whenever the reading is only possible in forward direction, that's why we always read in forward direction. So 3 to 5 strand, and the another strand is having 5 to 3. Here the thymine, adenine, guanine, cytosine, guanine, thymine. If you go through the hydrogen bonds, so in between GC or CG, 3 hydrogen bonds are there, and in between A and T, 2 hydrogen bonds are there. The strand which is having a 3 to 5 forward direction, this strand lead for the process of replication. Therefore, you remember, this is called the leading strand. So leading strand, whenever you remember, leading strand, parental strand, 3-0, 5-0, yaad rakhiyega. And when we study about the lagging strand, so lagging strand means, you remember, the strand which show the backward synthesis of DNA. DNA replication can be take place in forward as well as backward direction. Secondly, DNA replication is always take place when we study about the polymerase 3. So replication is always proceed in 5-2-3 direction. So replication always take place in 5-2-3 direction. It take place in forward as well as in backward direction. The strand of DNA which show the forward DNA synthesis, that DNA strand is called as leading strand. पेरेंटल लीडिंग स्ट्रैंड का डीएनए का पोजीशन याद रखे और सीक्वेंस किस डायरेक्शन में होंगे 3-5. द स्ट्रैंड विच शो द बैकवर्ड सिंथेसिस और डिसकंटिन्यूस सिंथेसिस ऑकाजर की फ्रेगमेंट्स के फॉर्म में होता है यहाँ पर. दोज लैगिंग स्ट्रैंड्स यू रिमेम्बर आर शोइंग द डायरेक्शन इन 5-2-3 एंड डिसकंटिन्यूस सिंथेसिस इज ऑलवेज टेक प्लेस ऑन लैगिंग स्ट्रैंड. नाउ हाउ डज द प्रोसेस इज टेक प्लेस, this you simply remember, this is the parental strand. Now here we come towards the replication of DNA and five, and this is 3-5. This part you remember. Suppose this is a parental DNA. Whenever DNA replication begins, the primer molecule, always primer is a molecule of 20 nucleotide nearly, and this primer is bind at the third end of DNA and provide a site for polymerase 3. So polymerase 3 is bind to the primer, and then the polymerase 3 start to synthesize the new DNA or daughter copy of DNA according to the nitrogen base sequence available on the parental strand. Okay, now suppose yahan par whatever sequence may be present, suppose the parental strand is having ATAGCGAC sequence. So on this parental strand, opposite to this TATCGCTG is available, and now the new DNA strand or daughter copy of DNA strand synthesized. So this synthesized as a TATCGCTG. Okay. Now when the DNA synthesis is take place on the another parental strand, this is this strand. So here only this much strand is open, and the primer is bind at this side. And this primer again start the DNA replication, but this DNA replication is take place in backward direction according to those. यहाँ पे sequence आपका होगा GACGATA. Clear? So whatever sequence be there according to complementary base pairing ke according new strand is available or synthesized by DNA polymerase. Now here you remember the helicase enzyme is present here. By that time, jab tak yahan pe aapka kya ho raha hai, new strands are synthesized, the helicase starts its activity and result in the denaturation. So meanwhile, till the time when the DNA replication proceed in these two parental separated strand, helicase again proceed in forward direction, and it will result in the formation of separation of these further two DNA. So in this way, helicase move in forward direction, isolate or denaturation of DNA will be result. So because of that, double-stranded DNA become converted into single-stranded DNA on this DNA where the third end is there. So primer molecule already present at the third end. The DNA polymerase, now this DNA polymerase proceed the forward replication or proceed the replication in continuous way. So the strand which show the 3-5 direction, this strand is actually called, it lead for the process of replication. That's why it is called as leading strand. Whereas on this strand, initially the replication of this much of DNA is take place. Now this much of strand get denatured. So the second molecule of primer is bind and the second molecule of DNA polymerase synthesize this much segment of the DNA. So this part, when the DNA replication nearly reaches to or completed the 3/4 part of DNA. So we clearly appear the different DNA segments are appear on one strand, and one strand of DNA involve in the continuous DNA synthesis. So DNA which involve in continuous DNA synthesis, that is the leading strand, and this strand is called as parental DNA. Basically this is called as a lagging strand. So here you remember what, now you clear what is the difference between the leading and lagging strand. So lagging strand in simple term you remember always show the backward DNA synthesis. Lagging strand ka direction aapka kya hoga, the lagging strand direction is 5 to 3. Nitrogen bases I am not explaining here, because one time you clear how the nitrogen bases are synthesized or formed. Clear? Now if you go through this diagram is called as Y fork of DNA replication. The diagram is provided in NCERT. By this diagram you clearly know this is the DNA strand, parental DNA strand show 3 to 5. On this DNA strand, primer is bind and then the replication is proceed in forward direction. But if you come towards this strand, so this strand show the replication in discontinuous manner, and because of that the small fragments of DNA are synthesized. These fragments were first time discovered by the Okazaki, so therefore these fragments are called as Okazaki fragments. And again this is one of the most important question for your upcoming NEET exam, that the Okazaki fragments are synthesized on. Okazaki fragment, you remember, they are always synthesized on lagging strand. What is the direction of lagging strand? So you remember direction of lagging strand is 5 to 3. Okazaki fragments are synthesized in which direction? So DNA synthesis, always remember, the DNA synthesis is always be take place in 5 to 3 direction, though it take place in forward direction or it may be take place in backward direction. Okay, so in this way slowly both the strand gets separated and undergoes in replication or the synthesis of new DNA molecule. Those DNA molecule are identical to the parental DNA because they show the complementary base pairing. Okay, now what is happening, the lagging strand DNA show the Okazaki fragment, so the third enzyme is involved in this process and the ligase enzyme start its activity, and by that activity Okazaki fragments ke beech mein whatever gap or nick is present, that nick is sealed. So Okazaki ligase, you remember, ligase is normally, ligase ko hum kya keh rahe hain, ligase is a sealing enzyme. So the gap which is present in between Okazaki fragment is sealed by the ligase enzyme, and in that way the two DNA to be synthesized by the replication of DNA. So student, this you all remember for the process of DNA replication. The most important statements again I revise here for within a 4-5 minutes, that replication you remember only take place in S phase of cell cycle. Secondly, replication ka meaning sabhi ko ab clear hai. Mode of DNA replication semi-conservative, Michelson and Stahl ke experiment ko yaad rakhiye. E. coli kyo select kiya hai, what is the replication time period for the E. coli, which isotopes he use, and NH4Cl mein N14, N15 ko yaad rakhiye. Cesium chloride density gradient method use kiya hai for the separation of the DNA. Okay, that diagram is provided for the Michelson and Stahl experiment, so you go through that diagrammatic explanation for the your upcoming NEET exam. After that when we come towards the requirement, so in addition to number of requirement, enzymatic requirements are more. So 3 enzymatic requirement as I discussed earlier, you go through that part and remember all the 3 important enzymes: helicase for the denaturation of DNA or unwinding of enzyme, polymerase 3 or Kornborg enzyme bhi keh rahe hain. So polymerase 3 for the synthesis of new strands of DNA, replication always take place in 5 to 3, leading strand show the 3 to 5 and lagging strand show 5 to 3 direction. Okay, all these things, and Okazaki fragment finally kahan pe form honge, they are the backwardly synthesized DNA fragments. which are formed on the lagging strain. So this is all about for the DNA replication. For next video sessions and for most important topic for the NEET upcoming exam, you stay connected with the channel. The students who are connected today, they subscribe my channel, like my videos, and by that time stay motivated, stay hydrated, and be positive for your upcoming examination.